solution, and also the fact that Kennen is super ungankable for an Udyr. You can't run down the Kennen when he's got the E to run away.
What?
Excuse?
Is it an Ivern top? It's an Ivern top! Now, I've seen LS's tier list,
yep.
And he put Ivern, I think, in A or S tier, just because of the Moonstone with the staff.
Yep.
So, I think...
Seeing the Conqueror here could potentially mean that Dan has something different planned and different in mind. There are a few Stridebreaker games out there floating around in high ELO, but we'll find out what the option is momentarily. As Torre is going to be in a little bit of trouble here, will be forced to flash out to safety, trading that for Trimby's Ignite. So again, overall, very positive trade for the team. Not clear if Inspired was spotted now that he has had time to even things out. It's only about 6 difference.
Yeah, they're going to pick up the Dragon, which is quite surprising. You know, they have the stronger early game junglers because of the lane prios, not necessarily in a 1v1, but just in terms of lane prios, they have way more sort of ways to start the Dragons. But Trimby's moving up to top side, Inspire's there as well. The wave is stacking against Kryze. He's no mana, so he needs to back off here, but I think they're going to stop him from being able to do so. Trimby has to flash. Kryze needs to react in time.
Flashed out.
Doesn't even
Swirl Seed. Yeah, not just too easy to pick that one up. That's going to be first blood for Rogue. Really solid play here. And got to say, immediate call out to Trimby. Brand new player on the lineup, not missing a beat. Roaming with the jungle.
You get move speed, you get ability power. So all these things just boost up your team. And you can see Kryze is stacking in waves. Trimby does go a bit aggressive.
Looks like trading back.
Trade a little bit back there, like you said. And Rogue just want to wave. And I don't think Exile has enough tempo on the map to be able to dive him, because I think Patrick might need to base as well. Torre needs to go back and collect some wards. And I just think that it's just a smart play overall from Rogue. And you can see that Trimby's doing the same thing that Kaiser did on the first game. He's making sure he covers Otto Amne, making sure he can get this wave securely, and he's around for the dive. They have no TPs. Larson isn't hovering, so it's going to be a 2v3 if they commit for the dive. But Exile don't have TPs either.
Trying to stay out of sight, because he knows if he goes undetected in this exchange,
yep.
And they try to force the dive, the Kennen ult plus the set will kill everyone. So, giving that respect though, as it does look like he was spotted out.
But XL's sending more numbers down here now. Rogue don't have any TPs to help this out, so it could be a 4-man dive. Looks like they're trying to make a cross-map play 100% because they know they're going to lose top tower.
It's going to be difficult. Has to be clean. Odo Omni, of course, no stopwatch here. A lot of members just looking for the lineup, trying to lay some damage
Kryze
down.
Down too.
But there's really no wave here to dive Odo Omni, so he has plenty of time to walk away. That said, Kryze on the way in, Daisy comes out, it'll be difficult to get out, but Odawamne, lightning rush to safety, and XL are behind the play now at this stage of the game. That's going to be second charge on the top lane for the Rift Herald, and we'll even see if XL can actually fully take down this tower. It's going to be so tanky.
XL is losing so much here. They're sharing XP, Patrick needs to base, they're all down on tempo, they're losing top waves, Dragon spawning in 30 seconds, so Rogue have taken top tower, they've got all the gold on the Kalista, they've based, they've come back on the map.
Drake, there was a response play, so it wasn't taken freely. But it is something that they can count in their favor. That said, we're seeing Han Sama consistently left on his own. Big strength of this Kalista is, as we learned from the Shy, doesn't really...
Ready to get a fight going because they are so far ahead in gold.
Yeah, and of course, one of the things that's important to consider as well is that while Ivern is going to be looking to abuse a lot of the new itemization, Odawamne is going to walk away. Odawamne might have a similar story, although he is going to have to hightail it out of here. That's that red buff that you talked about, Cadrel.
Yeah.
Kryze able to grab that one for free. But important to note, new protobelt. It's even harder to get away from the Kennen.
Yeah, traded flashes there. I think that benefits XL a little bit. Good play from Kryze there. I think the Kennen flash wolf is very dangerous. So Dan running onto Larson here. He has flash.
Runs out to safety. Trying to get some damage back. Now, check out that very low mana. This should be an easy follow-up. Immediate TP now coming in. The team is all playing together. There's no ultimate for Odawamne, but that's not going to stop committing to this play. Not a big wave, though. So might feel like a little bit
really on the table quite yet. It will be an Ocean Soul, but with both teams at 1-1, you have to wait a long time for that really to be a threat.
More items, but they know the Herald's going down. They're looking for something on the cross map. That's how these teams work. If something happens on one side of the map, you need to get something on the other side. So denying Hansa wave, trying to take the tower, play things, but XL just going to opt in, try and get the bot tower here and trade for the Herald. But that does mean that someone has to catch the top wave. So Kryze is going to base, knows the play is kind of secured. He's going to run towards top lane to catch the wave that Otto Amne is pushing in. And yeah, good play from XL, making sure they trade objectives and not kind of giving up everything.
Yeah, I definitely. And I think a good call from Hansama to back off there. Obviously, we saw Odawamne sit under that tower.
Patrick's going to have to base. Odawamne pushed in top and moved down. So that means all of XL are kind of funneled into the top side of the map or in their base. Inspired puts the Herald mid to make sure they have the prio. So they can move towards the Drake whenever they want. And they should have full vision. So once Hans pushes out this bot wave, I think they're going to turn towards a dragon. And that could be the second dragon for Rogue unless XL think they can stop it in time.
Back off coming through here. Not. Come on.
Ooh, that means.
Oh.
Clutch.
I was going to say, that would be awkward. Certainly not the biggest problem, but now Inspired has started the Drake, as mentioned. Dan can try to push in here.
Trimby, he's in the bush. has the flash as well, so he can flash flip Patrick if he walks too far up, but I like that XL's contesting this.
The Lantern, Trimby has to be careful here. Has he stayed for too long? He's gonna get pulled back. Hansama is gonna save the day for now. He's going right back into the team where it's gonna all, but he gets immediately taken down. Odawamne now stepping forward, has used the rocket belt. That steroid is gone and he has no flash available. He's trying to move in, but Dan's just gonna take it away. XL keeping much cooler heads in that fight, and Rogue are getting massively punished. Well played.
Yeah, huge play from XL there. Trimby tried to find the engage. He did get a five-man knock-up on the Callisto.
Yeah, I think that ward has been spotting out Dan,
the one over the Baron pit, so Rogue's trying to push them out, make sure Larson can keep this push up.
Trimby.
Trimby does show himself there. Larson pushed in the wave.
He's good hook.
Yep.
Spire going to be in trouble now, running for the hills. And we'll leap out there with the watch out Eve just to get a little distance between himself and the XL lineup. But XL doing what they can to fight, to take control of their topside jungle as Larson will manage to take most of this Krug camp away, and it's...
There's a lot of follow-up on the Rogue lineup. They have the set flash whoop, they have the flash forwards from Odawamne as well, and Odawamne is looking for the flank position. I think Kryze did spot him.
He did.
So he should have to back off here, but it's really important the fact that he's below XL, so XL have to go forwards.
And Tribute is incredibly low too, which means we cannot really see a set engage at this point, especially now that the grit has all been taken away, and you do see Rogue recognizing that. Instead, they're going to start pressuring down mid lane, knowing that they have to give this Ocean up. Now, this will be a positive goal trade, but will mean that in the next Drake, they will have to fight
the Megatron Cloak?
Megatron Cloak. So we'll do a little bit more magic damage, split his damage profile more, and potentially get Trimby caught out as well, as now we see Trimby just instantly deleted.
Yeah, Trimby's positioning is not being great
either, and support items, just in general, very strong. The limitation, you have to use them with somebody else, but let me tell you, when you can use them, they're just good. But for now, Odawamne gonna be leaping into the fight. The follow-up is there, the dunk back down. Rogue certainly taking priority, but Patrick looking to make the difference as Trimby's in the midst of it, everything, and Larson is just throwing down damage left and right. Moonstone be damned. Rogue are not interested. That is the ace.
That's a huge mistake from XL. I think they thought they were stronger than they are. I mean, they were split up. They walked in to try and get vision. They get caught out, and they managed to lose the fight 5-0. So like I said, I think one team fight is going to blow this game open. So I think Rogue going to get this Baron obviously quite easily. And now that gold lead just swung into a 7k value. They're going to get the mid tier 2. They're going to get the Baron. And I think that just all comes off one small mistake from XL from getting too cocky to get the vision control. I think they weren't grouped up enough. I think the idea was good, but the X control, the whole map, they should be able to get this dragon away from XL. Maybe XL can group up and try to find something.
4k damage coming in from Larson in that fight. Absolutely massive performance. But Trimby should just be dead here. Again, cast or cursing him, I feel like, Cato.
The second
you praise him, he instantly dies. That said, should not cost Rogue too much. Maybe cuts a little bit of effective time off this Baron, as Rogue can't fully commit to any big objectives. But tier 2s should be pretty easy pickings, at least for Odawamne in this circumstance.
Yeah, just being careful. He doesn't know where XL are, so just making sure he gets the top tier 2. And like you said, it's not the end of the world.
Once or twice, but it's hard for me to say if this build is enough to overcome 10k deficit. I would definitely assume no, but I know that it balances out a little bit of that. That said, Hansama will not be balanced, and he will instantly just one-shot Patrick, and that is really the sole consistent damage source on this XL lineup, so it can start to poke back here, but Rogue should just be able to have a field day on this base, and XL may just lose in this moment if Rogue can collapse this many waves.
Yeah, Patrick's dead for 30 seconds. They're definitely going to get double in him here. The hook does land, so Trimby is going to get a little bit of poke on him, but I think that Rogue can just go forwards. See, Hans just diving in. He's so fed, has the QSS to stop the audio stun, and do they want to go for more, or do they want to turn and get this dragon? Because I think the dragon is way more important and way less risky, and essentially secures you 5 more minutes of just...
Yeah. ...was responsible for carrying XL last season, so to see him essentially picked off back-to-back in 2 fights, just feels like GG for XL. They cannot, for both of the squishier members on the Rogue lineup, both those AP threats, so they can't really burst those guys out. Similarly, we've got QSSs, we've got cleanses. They cannot simply bear stun someone and one-shot them. It's going to take a little bit more than that for XL to find a one fight.
Yeah, they're trying to fight on this bush line that they have. You can see the bush line, trying to keep the Zoe in there, trying to use poke, trying to get the hooks out. But the problem is they have to answer top and mid wave. They're crashing into the tier 4s. They have to answer it. The Ivern doesn't have wave clear, so they need Patrick on this Aphelios to make sure he can push out these waves and then just keep answering Rogue's bot waves. And Rogue, do they want to go for a 5-man dive? Do they want to just keep poking this tower down? Or do they just want to turn towards the Baron later on in the game?
And they're going to leap forward. Has the shielding coming in on him, but has to be careful. He tries to overcommit. Trimby can go away and looking for the big back. Dunk is going to get immediately taken out, but there's Odawamne with the follow-up. Protobelt, rocket belting rather his way to safety, but Rogue have just absolutely decimated XL in that fight. 2 quick kill pickups traded for their support. Absolutely a positive exchange with minion waves crashing in as well. You have to feel like this might just be over. Patrick whiffing the ult too. Just insult to injury.
Yeah, 2 for 1 here, and Rogue are trying to go for towers, but Patrick.
Big snare. Decent damage. Healing now coming back from Hatsama. He has so much lifesteal now in this situation.
Oh, Larson!
Oh, 80 carries. Might as well stack two. Chekalad goes down, and that's going to be it. Rogue, absolute dominance in this game versus Excel, as they're going to close out their first one with a win.
Yeah, I think Rogue played really clinically. They only made a couple of mistakes, just overextending for vision around the dragon fight as well, especially just mistakes. Maybe not so much poor decision making, but just kind of going into early, wait for more teammates. And I think that just comes with more experience from Trimby. I think a couple more games, he shouldn't make those mistakes later on, but you can see the core components of Rogue just showing up, you know. Otto Amne having a great game, Inspired and Larson playing pretty much flawlessly, and Hans doing what